Hi, I'm Damon Smith, Extension Field Crops Pathologist for the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Today we're out here in a field of dent corn, and we're looking at some pretty significant disease here. We're noticing quite an epidemic of tar spot. Tar spot is a new disease of field corn here in the state of Wisconsin. And tar spot's pretty new to actually the entire U.S., being first found in Indiana in 2015. Since the first find in Indiana, we have found tar spot the last several seasons in 2016 and 2017 in Wisconsin. However, it hasn't been a very significant disease, usually just causing some blemishes on the leaves and having little impact on yield. In 2018, however, that situation has changed. We now have pretty significant disease, as you can see here with this particular field, and we're studying the impacts and trying to understand why that is. Tar spot is caused by a fungus called Phylloxera maidus, and in Latin America it's been known for some time down there. However, it usually occurs in combination with another fungus called Monogryphella maidus. In the U.S., we don't know if we have Monogryphella maidus, however, we are actively trying to understand if it is here, given the severity of symptoms we see. The symptoms of tar spot are actually quite interesting. You can see as the disease first starts on the green foliage here, you get this sort of tar splattered appearance. As the disease progresses, it then converts into more of an eye spot type symptom that you can see here, where we get some necrosis around that tar spot lesion. Now, if you look at the literature from Central and South America, we know that in order to have that significant eye spot lesion or have actual necrosis, we have to have that second fungus, Monogryphella maidus, present. We don't think, again, that particular fungus is here in the U.S., but it is interesting that we're noticing this type of damage on these particular leaves. As symptoms progress past the tar spot appearance on the leaves and into that eye spot symptom, eventually we get to a situation like this, where we have complete death of the plants and early senescence of the plants. This is a result, we think, mostly of the damage caused by tar spot, maybe in association with other fungi. However, we're in the process of trying to work that out and understand the biology around this particular disease. Now, as we move forward into the harvest time, it's important to scout fields, look at the severity of tar spot, because we're noticing that as these fields prematurely dry, we're also noticing loss in stalk integrity. Therefore, lodging and yield reductions from lodging will also be a problem. By confirming fields hit hard by tar spot, you can harvest those fields first and try to get on top of it before significant lodging takes place in those particular fields. As you chop silage, it's important to keep testing for mycotoxins. We're also noticing more ear rot as these plants are stressed by tar spot. More ear rot may lead to higher levels of mycotoxin, such as vomitoxin. The only way to know what levels of vomitoxin you actually have there or other mycotoxins is to simply test. There are many labs here in the U.S. that can test for these mycotoxins, and we've included a table in our A3646 publication, table 2-16, which gives a list of certified labs that can test for mycotoxins. In terms of the actual effects on yield and quality, we're not exactly sure what will actually happen here. However, it is safe to assume that we'll likely at least see losses in test weight. However, as farmers have started to cut corn here in southwestern Wisconsin, we're actually noticing pretty significant yield reductions and also off test weights. And again, this is a result of the fact that these corn plants are basically senescing too early and can't finish filling out those ears. We're also looking at fungicide applications and their possible efficacy against tar spot. We know very little about fungicides, and at this time, we can't make any clear management recommendations. However, as you move forward and prepare for the 2019 field season, it's important to visit those hybrid trials, make some plans to look for hybrids with resistance, as I think we will be dealing with tar spot in the 2019 field season. We do believe that the tar spot fungus can overwinter here in the upper Midwest, so being prepared for 2019 will be extremely important. For more information about tar spot or other corn diseases, please visit badgercropdoc.com or contact your local extension agent.